Welcome again. So today's experiment is to study and evaluate the transfer function of AC servo motor. So the apparatus required for this experiment are AC servo motor kit, connecting wires and a multimeter we required for this. This is our block diagram here. This is our input EC of S. EC of S is voltage of control winding. Then we have the block K1. K1 is slope of control phase voltage and torque characteristics. Then we have the summing junction. Here we have two inputs. One is EC of S, another one is TL. We will give the input separately. First we will give EC of S, at that time TL will be 0. Then we will give TL and our input EC of S will be 0. TL is our low torque. Then this block represents 1 by JS plus B is the motor, this block represents the transfer function of the motor. Then we have the feedback K2. K2 represents the slope of speed and torque characteristics. Then we have the output the omega of S, and that is the angular speed, and then we integrate omega of S, we get theta of S, that is angular displacement. So here J of S is written what J is inertia, inertia constant of motor, and B is frictional coefficient. So this is the block diagram. Now what we are going, first of all we are giving low torque we will keep 0 and we will give EC of S. So our transfer function theta of S divided by EC of S, input by output, that transfer function will be Km divided by S tau m S plus 1. So here Km is K1 divided by B plus K2, and tau of MS is J divided by B plus K2. So at this first transfer function, this first equation, we have kept TL is equal to 0. So we will repeat this. Now we will keep EC of S equal to 0, that is here. So our theta of S divided by TL of S, output by input, that will be 1 by S KN divided by TM of S plus 1. Where Kn is motor gain constant. So here we have three parameters. One is Km, another one is Kn, and we have Tm, tau. So Km is motor constant, Tn is motor gain constant, and tau is time constant. So we will now see practically how we will get this Km, then we will see how we will get Kn, then we will see how we will get time constant on the apparatus, that is AC servo motor kit. Now we will see practically. So this is our AC servo motor unit where we will get this transfer function. First of all, we will get Km. So Km, for Km you will not get directly Km from this. You have to evaluate a formula, that is Km is equal to pi n divided by 30 EC of S. Pi n divided by 30 EC of S. You will get so here pi is constant, 30 is constant. So we can evaluate EC of S here, EC of S is here, and we can get n, that is speed here. So now we will connect this and we will check how we will calculate the values for Km. Now I will switch on this AC servo motor, and this is EC, that is the voltage, control voltage. This is the meter. Okay, on step 1, we will check how much is the voltage, that is 3.93. You have to note down this voltage, and you will check the speed. So for speed, you have to look here, how much is the speed, that is almost 1183 RPM. So this is the voltage and this is the speed. You know the formula, that is pi n divided by 30 EC. Pi is constant, 30 is constant, and you will get the speed, that is n here, and voltage EC of S, that is here. So you will calculate three values. First on step 1 EC of S, then you will check on step 2, that is step 2, that is 7.68 voltage, and you will see how much is the speed, and you will again calculate the value Kn, that is pi n divided by 30 EC of S. Pi is constant, 30 is constant, here is the speed and here is the voltage. And again you will repeat this on step 3rd, EC on step 3rd. So on step 3rd, the voltage is 11.49 volts and the speed is 1990 rpm. Now you have to get the mean, so you have calculated values for step 1, step 2 and step 3. So now you will get the mean k1 plus k2 plus k3 divided by 3 and you will get kn. Okay, that will be approximate around 29.4 rpm per volt, you will get that. Okay, good, this is for how we will calculate km. Now we have to get the second parameter, that is kn. For kn you have to first calculate kg, that is generator constant. Your kg is equal to E naught divided by ns. So you have to get E naught divided by ns. Where from you will calculate E naught? That is from here. E naught is here. You will get E naught from here. Okay, and you have to get ns speed, that is here. Okay. So kg is E naught divided by ns. Again you will repeat this for step 1, step 2 and step 3. Okay, step on step 1 you will check it, and you will again check it on step 2, and you will check it on step 3, and you will get the mean, and that your kg will be almost equal to 1.77 into 10 power minus 3 volt per rpm. Now again you have to get TL, low torque. So your low torque is equal to 30 kg I divided by pi. 30 kg I divided by pi. 30 is constant, pi is constant. So you have to calculate kg and I. Kg you already have calculated, now you have to get I. So for I you need this multimeter. So this multimeter, I will calculate this, how I will calculate this multimeter. This is your ground, I will connect it here, and this I, so I load, I will connect it here. So now I will calculate I, how much is I. Okay, you can see the I here. First, because my now load is connected, because step 1 and step 1 is that is means no load, so your current will be 0 because there is no load, so your current is 0. Now I will, when I will increase this load, so my current will increase. Look, your current is now almost 11.0 microampere on step 2, and step 3 the current will again, because the load increases, the current will increase, so 19.2 microampere. So your you can again see on step 1 there is no current because there is no load, on step 2 there is some load, so there is the current is almost 10.8 microampere. On step 3 you can check it. Okay, now you again I have shown you the formula for TL. You have 30 is constant, pi is constant, kg you already have calculated, and I you have seen here for step 1, step 2 and step 3. For step 1 I was 0 because there was no load, so you will get these values on this table. Okay, you need ns that is here, I that you have calculated, and load the formula that I have shown above. You know omega is equal to 2 pi n divided by 60. So you will put load 1 and load 2, then you will substitute these values in these two equations, and then you will compare these equations and you will get kn now, that is 32.96 in 10 power minus 3 volt ampere per rpm. You have calculated kn, now you have to calculate time constant. Now we have to calculate time constant, that will be displayed here, time constant. For that you have to, first of all you have to measure E naught, how much is E naught. So you will check output voltage E naught, how much is that V naught, that will be displayed here on the motor, and see how much is the voltage E naught. This is the E naught, that is 3.93. So now you have to get the, for time constant you have to get the 63.3% of this voltage, that is almost equal to 2.5. So you will change this knob E naught to here ES, and you will set the voltage here, that is 2.5, you will set here 2.5 volts. Then what you will do, you will switch off this motor unit and wait for 30 seconds. After 30 seconds you will get the time constant here, how much is the time constant. Time constant will be displayed after 30 seconds. So after After 30 seconds, you will on this and you will check how much is the time constant. That is almost here 60 milliseconds and it should be around 100. So you will check this time constant here. This is the experiment. So we have calculated Km, Kn and Tn, and you have to put this in transfer function. So you will get the values. Thank you.